Hi guys, welcome to the Tonewood Gearhead University. Chris here.
And Guillaume.
So, today we're going to talk about something really interesting, and it's kind of a hot theme, and yeah, probably it will turn into a debate, right?
It has to.
It must. So we're going to talk, Tonewood make a difference at all or not? But first of all, please subscribe. That meat helps us a lot, and it doesn't hurt, and we'll be really happy.
Yeah, it's free. That's a good point. And then you'll be able to see that there are new guitar videos every Thursday, which is nice.
If you don't want to hear us talking, you want to hear the comparisons, you can click the links in the description, and you'll be right there. Otherwise, we have the beautiful Engel Artist Edition, which is the 100 version, 100 watt version. And it's a really sweet amp. It has all the Engel flavor to it, but with a little bit of a vintage British vibe to it. It's a super nice amp. Clean, low gain, high gain. Doesn't matter what we want, it will do it.
And it's loud.
It's so loud. It's so awesome. And we have a couple of beautiful guitars, which we'll see about. Yeah. Okay, so these two guitars. First is Harley Benton, which started out stock.
Yeah.
Is not anymore.
It's not anymore.
Not at all, because it's actually owned by my colleague Barney. Thanks, Barney, for loaning your guitar. He swapped the pickups. These are the Fender Custom Shop No Coster pickups. Oh, right. And he also swapped the pods and electronics to 250K CDS pots, so it is Fender Custom Shop spec. And the woods, maple neck, end board, and a Basswood body with this cool brown paisley finish.
Yeah, it's a lovely guitar. I'm just gonna try and keep it clean.
No chance, it's
too
dark.
No, probably not. But it's a gorgeous guitar, and it's really comfortable to play. We've got a really thick neck to it. It's just chunky, you can feel that.
It feels right.
Yeah, it feels right.
How a Tele is supposed to be. Yeah. Big and...
Exactly. In your face.
And this is actually 1953 reissue Fender Custom Shop team built guitar with the same no-custer pickups and the same CDS 250K pots and the same maple neck. The body is the big difference, because this is a selected ash body. Which selected means that they check the tonal structure and, of course, the weight.
Ash is a really unstable sort of wood. Yeah. Like you've got really heavy ash, really light one. And so it's really interesting in the sense that we're comparing tone woods, because ash can go from one end to the other, and it's really cool.
Exactly. Let's give it a go. All right. What do you want to hear? Neck pickup? Running, bridge pickup?
Yeah, probably bridge.
All right, cool. That's going to be the clean channel, which... It's not that clean anymore because we drive the amp pretty nice.
Just a bit.
Yeah. All right. So just a couple of chords, and I play exactly the same thing on the other guitar.
Yeah.
That you get the point right away.
Yeah. We just want to, there's going to be the same picking, the same guy doing the comparison, because otherwise we pick differently, we play differently, so there's going to be a difference.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
It'll be doing both.
All right. So just a couple of simple chords.
Time to shine.
Yeah. Something?
Yeah, you can slightly. It's not that big of a difference, but just the weight difference is so massive. So that thing is light as a feather.
It's ridiculous.
That one's really heavy.
Yeah. But even though Basswood isn't a heavy wood, but it's like a normal weight, 3.65 kilos.
It's just that one
and
is
that's
lighter.
Even lighter. Yeah. But what I hear is absolutely the difference in bass and the mid range is different. And I'm not at all saying that this guitar sounds 10 times better than this one, which it costs.
Really
it costs 10 times more than this one. I mean, the guitar will be under 200 euros wherever you check for current prices, and the pickups are 100 and something euros, and the pots are like 6 euros. So it's, you know, if you do it yourself, if you're okay with soldering and stuff, that's a pretty fast and super effective mod.
Yeah.
And you pay nearly nothing for a guitar that sounds on the level of a really high quality and expensive guitar. It will sound different though. And that's the only point what I want to make.
Yeah.
What counts for me, it's not like you buy an expensive guitar, it will sound for every one of us 10 times better.
Yeah.
It will sound different.
Oh, that's a really good point. But the thing is, I'm just going to be the devil's advocate for a while and try and say that Tonewoods don't make much of a difference. And to be honest, you have a slight difference in the clean channel. You can hear that a bit. But if you're going to drive it or tweak the amp a bit, do some mods, they're going to sound exactly the same.
Let's try.
I mean, I'm not saying that Tonewoods is a myth, because it's not. Everything that's made of matter has a resonance frequency, and it's going to resonate at a different frequency. So there is an inherent difference between those woods. But I can't really hear it. So like, if you're going to drive those and tweak the amp, there's not going to be much of a difference.
Let's try that. Go a little bit gaining. We'll try a low gain setting and maybe at the end a little high gain, because, you know, who knows what happens. Play more staccato, like shorter notes, and also palm mute. We get the bass frequencies and also the harmonics and everything, because that's probably the most noticeable thing. I think if you're talking about, you know, clean or low gain distorted, you hear more of a difference. Absolutely distorted, because even though there's a compression going on and your lower volume stuff will be louder and your peaks will just, you know, pull back a little. The harmonics and all the overtones and all the interesting nice things about a guitar sound will also be more noticeable.
Yeah, of course. But the thing is, it's in the clean tone, so it's obviously going to end up in the distorted channel. It's in there.
Yeah.
And it makes sense that there is a difference. But then again, how would you say, like, was this one snappier or less?
More growly. Yeah. I felt definitely that I don't have to fight with the bass end. I mean, with palm mutings, it's all there without, you know, hitting the string that hard. I mean, I do anyhow, but that's how I pick.
That's your thing.
Yeah,
but
it was just naturally happening.
Yeah.
I hit the string. Let's try that again. Just some palm muted, you know, E6 chugging.
Oh yeah, right. Okay.
And before you say, yeah, probably the pickup is way higher than I've said it with the ruler yesterday. Both pickups
exactly the same height.
Exactly the same height. And that's the thing, because of course you have your strings, and you will be right if you say the strings move. They all set in motion picking, and the pickups are magnetic microphones, you could say, and they'll, you know, grab all the information that's useful and turn it into signal, and your amp will make it loud. Sure, but your strings will behave differently if they have different metal materials here, or a different nut, or a different wood here, or on the neck. And that's just how it is. It's a mixture of all the components, which all matter. How much? Okay, I'll never say it's like 40% body and like, you know, 20% saddles No, who knows, you know, nobody could say this, you hear right away.
Oh yeah, there was...
There was like shocking,
yeah,
there
was a difference. There was a big difference.
And I'm not trying to make my point like this guitar sounds crappy and that sounds awesome. This, I think I would prefer to more stratty type of sounds, like a funk stuff, you know, if you play open stuff. It's just
the
mids are super strong, and there you go, Ash, where you think that it only has treble and nothing else.
Yeah.
A lightweight Ash body will give you such a mid push, it's shocking. That's the difference.
Yeah, right, it is.
And this sounds more like a stretty telly sort of sound, and this is like all the way 50s specs, you know, with the fitting wood and the fitting pickups, and this gives you a different sort of flavor. I've just swapped strings an hour ago, and both are the same 10 gauge Fender pure nickel strings. Same old, same material, same gauge, same everything. Nice. Pickups are, of course, set exactly to the same spot, and you know.
Same action as well.
Yeah, of course. I've said it. I mean, this I've said earlier because it's my guitar.
Yeah.
But so I have it how I like it, but I've said it yesterday. So.
All right. And they're like, both new. This is not a. It's not
from the 50s or something. No, I bought this last year, and my colleague has this for like 2 or 3 years. Or something like this. So around the same age as well, and I mean, you know.
Right on.
All right, let's move on.
Yeah. I'm confused. I was not expecting that much of a difference. So now we're going to try on the same comparison with EMG pickups, active pickups, and see if those make a difference. And that's probably where you don't expect, you're not expecting any differences, because there's a preamp, it's an active pickup, the signal's going to be already transformed on its way out of the guitar, again in the amp. This is a KH602 Kirk Hammett LTD guitar. It has, so basically we're just going to use the bridge pickups for this demo, and for the sake of having the exact same thing, which is the EMG 81 active pickup. Otherwise, but pretty much the same guitars, three-piece maple neck, rosewood fingerboard, and the exception, of course, is the bodywood, which are respectively
Mahogany
and
Alder.
Alder. All right, there you go.
And one more thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
Because it's so hard to find super identical guitars with different body tone woods. This was the closest we could get.
Yeah.
So this is a ball tone, and that's a set neck. So there you go.
We're going to have to take that into consideration. But if I've got to say and repeat again, there's an active pickup with a preamp. I'm really not sure that there's going to be any difference to be heard, to be honest.
And I'm super interested, because
bolt-on or not, with EMG pickups, it's just like everyone's saying that they're so compressed, so artificial, they all suck out the tone of like the guitar personality. I know that's going on YouTube as well, but I've had guitars with EMG. I'm not the best EMG fan, but I like them. They're responsible for some of my favorite tones. Like Devin Townsend's been using EMG forever.
And or this
Metallica.
Guy.
Yeah, I should have started with him. James Hetfield as well. I don't hate EMG at all, but I still feel like they compress the sound and it's going to suck the guitar's personality and the wood personality, and we're not going to get such a strong differences with the tellies.
And I'm pretty sure that that's not going to happen.
We're going to see that.
Let's check it out. What do you say? Try it sort of clean first?
Yeah. Clean, half clean. So again, same action, same strings, and same pickup distance from... Yeah, right. Yeah. Exactly. What he said. Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know.
No, I didn't hear anything, any difference.
Oh, between the two?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, not really. Me neither. I was not expecting to hear a difference. Yeah.
Okay, I did actually, but there was nothing which I could, you know, like hang on to, like, whoa, have you heard that bass end or something?
No. Yeah, I could try.
Probably if we'd, you know, swap guitars 20 times, I would find something, but that's, you know, if I'm interested in that difference, I'm not sure. You know,
I was not expecting anything. So far, so good. I'm just going to try and do some, like...
Let's try something low gain.
Yeah,
what do you say?
Probably.
Like, sort of mid gain.
Yeah, right.
I won.
No. I mean, yeah, come on.
Yeah. I mean, it's not like one sounds good and then it sounds like...
Yeah, no, it's
weird.
Way different, but how come this one is way tighter and there's a lot more high end on this one?
As well as bass.
Why?
I mean...
How?
There you go, bolt on there.
How? Yeah, but this is sorcery.
What's wrong with that?
It should be the entire way around. This should not have more low and high end. And this.
Come on, relax, man.
I am not happy with this.
Actually, because of Alder, I mean, if you know about Tonewoods, it makes a hell of a lot of sense.
Yeah, no, it makes sense, but yeah. I was certain that with the MG preamp, you wouldn't hear that much of a difference.
Funny
enough, considering the clean tones were not different.
Exactly.
They were practically the same.
I was struggling.
So
it's like, no, I...
And now it's just obvious.
Yeah, and I exactly thought the opposite, that as soon as you go up with your gains, with your saturation, it just disappears, because it's so much going on that it's all gone. So let's try high gain.
Yeah, right.
What do you say?
Yeah.
Because that's, I think, the most interesting if you're playing MGs.
Right. Let's get our master on.
Bass.
Alright, so it turns out there is a difference. And it's just emphasized, it's really made obvious with high gain.
Yeah.
Right, there's so much more bass to
bigger.
This one.
Yeah.
I'm both confused and really excited that I found out something. It's alright, so which wood is that again?
Mahogany.
Yeah.
And this is Alder. And, you know, a well-known, typical thing, which is not always 100% is, but Mahogany is very famous for its lower mid-range, which is this growling, you know, sound. And Alder is a really snappy, sort of balanced, but a little bit more on the bright side sounding wood, which is super for sustain and clean stuff. But high gain, it's super tight. And this guitar is super tight.
It is.
You lose some of the bass end, of course, but because of the EMGs in it and the whole structure of the guitar, it's just super tight.
I'm not even mad, I'm impressed. It's just, all right, I felt strangely about bolt-on necks, but just to prove that whatever wood you're using, if it's well done, there are so many factors to be taken into consideration, but in this case, wood does make a difference.
Yeah. And it's not like
Damn.
The more a guitar costs, the more you will like it.
Nothing to do with this. And you have to go around the fact that every guitar, even if it's the same wood, the same tree, it's going to sound different.
Yeah.
It's going to resonate differently. And it's just
the beauty of wood.
I mean, it is.
I don't think we should deny that. I think we should really appreciate it and love the fact that guitars have their tonal correctors because of each and every component that's on it. I'm interested in the comments. Please do so. And if you hate, please hate. If you loved it or found it interesting, even better. And
tell us also if we're the only one hearing a difference there, because I don't think so. I really don't think so. I'm going deaf. I might be going deaf. But I think there's, like, even with EMG, and I was the last one thinking there would be a difference. I think there is one, and
it's not better or worse.
No, it's different. It's different.
That's all right. That's all the point what I wanted to make. I don't know.
I'm good with it. I'm good with different. That's fine.
All right. Every Thursday you have a new episode of some funny gearhead video, just like this one coming up. And if you don't want to miss it, click on the subscription button somewhere.
Subscribe.
I don't know. Philip, put the Thomann logo please somewhere on the screen. Feel free to find a nice spot, and you guys can click on it and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.